Hello everyone, welcome to another vlog on Introduction to Advertising Agencies. I'm Dr. Gitanjali Kalia, Associate Professor in the Mass Comm field, and in case you're liking my videos, do subscribe to my channel. In this video, we'll be discussing the topics like what is an advertising agency, evolution of an advertising agency, classifications, reason for hiring the agency, and how to select an agency. So let's understand first what is an advertising agency. An agency is an independent business organization that is irrespective of anyone's control, किसी का control नहीं है, composed of creative and business people, not engineers but creative people, who develop, prepare and place advertisements in the advertising medias such as radio, television, newspapers, for sellers. That means some companies, be that Maggie, be that Cadbury, seeking to find customers for their goods and services. And this definition is being given by American Association of Advertising Agencies. So let's understand how this advertising agency started. So the advertising agencies basically developed around 1840 when some individuals started to work as a sales representative. They basically used to sell the space of the newspapers for their clients on commission basis. For example, nowadays also we see a lot of newspapers hiring marketing executives to sell out the space for the newspapers, because advertisements are a major source of revenue for the newspapers or any other medium. So they used to buy a set of pages from the newspaper and sell that space at higher prices to make the profit. So this whole space brokers, those who used to sell out the space, were named as space brokers. And this further on developed over a period of time. This developed into the advertising agencies. And this whole concept of space selling and buying basically lasted for a period of 1840 to 1876. During this time only, very little emphasis was given on advertising planning and scheduling, media scheduling. Basically, when we decide what date, what time, which medium we have to give the advertisements. That is basically media scheduling and planning. So very little emphasis was placed onto it. It was more like ki jahan par space hai, jahan par space mil rahi hai, jisse mil rahi hai, uspe apni advertisements de do, right? So advertising commissions basically ranged from 10% to 35%, which was brought down to 15% unanimous decisions tha from all the agencies around 1960s. So now further, let's discuss the various types of advertising agencies, right? So the first type of the advertising agency we are going to discuss is a full service agency. I think as the title itself makes it clear, full service agency is the one which handles or which has all the departments of an advertising agency into it. Like they are basically in the process from the beginning to the end, everything is being handled by the full service agency, right? For it will plan also, it will create also, produces and place till the end advertisements in all the mediums. That is the responsibility of the full service. Next classification of agency is the media buying service agency. Well, these kind of agencies specializes in buying and selling the radio and the television time, and also the spaces for the newspapers, and reselling it to the advertisers and advertising agencies. For example, in case you want to buy a slot, in case you want to give your advertisement in 92.7, so basically these sort of agencies would either have the slots, drive time or a prime time slot, to sell it to you so that you can place your ad in that particular time period, or in a television, they sell the time slots in case whenever you want to insert your ad, and they also sell the space for the newspapers. They'll get your ads placed in a newspaper and in a radio and in a television according to the availability of the space in the slot. So next type of advertising agency is Creative Boutique. So this type of organization basically specializes in the creation of ads. For example, designing the print advertisement for you, or creating a radio jingle for you, or making a television advertisement for you. So they are just into the process of creating the advertisements for you. So these sort of agencies are known as the creative boutique. Another classification, or you say the fourth classification of an advertising agency, is in-house agency. In-house agencies are the one, they are basically agencies that work under a particular brand, right? So these type of agencies work for a single brand and handle all the creative and the media work of that particular brand. For example, Chail is the in-house agency of Samsung, right? So all the work of the Samsung, be that creative, media, or any type of the radio, television, print, digital, it's being done by Chail. Okay. So next and the last classification is interactive agencies. So these kind of agencies basically refer to the digital mode of communications. For example, they are into a process of making the online advertisements, mobile marketing, sending the personal messages on mobile. So they basically create the advertisements which are very interactive in nature, right? And are very innovative. So the next topic we are going to discuss is the structure of a full service agency. The details would be starting in another video. We'll be talking about the functions of each and every department. But just to understand, so here you can see a structure of a full service agency, where you have the creative services, accounts department, you have marketing services and the finance management. Creative basically comprises of the writers. Print productions are basically people, those who are into designing of a print ad or a hoarding or a brochure. You have broadcast productions people, those who make TV ads or radio jingles for you, right? And then also the one, those who are basically know where the most of the traffic follows. So ye creative log hain. Next on the list is account servicing, jisko hum client servicing bhi bolte hain. So account servicing basically are the one, those who handle the account. For example, in any advertising agency, Pepsi is one of the account. Similarly, other accounts can be Maggie, PNG, Incredible India, or the government sector, BJP. These are different accounts that a client servicing department handles. Then comes the marketing services, that is the media, research and sales promotion. Media, basically the way we have started, they are into buying and selling of the space and time, right? Research is basically done by the research department. For example, that is pre-testing and post-advertising research jo hoti hai, before the launch of the campaign and after the launch of the campaign jo research hoti hai, that is basically catered by the marketing department. And sales promotions, basically your discount offers and your gift card, coupons, jo bhi sales promotions ka part hota hai, they're all taken care by the marketing department. And then finance, of course, payment of your employees, keeping a track record of your clients' payments, and keeping a track record of the payment of the jitna bhi financial cash flow hai aapki agency ka, that is taken care by the finance department or the finance management. So ye pura ek full service agency ke andar all the departments will work together from the start till the end, jab tak aapki ad nahi chale jati hai and the client is satisfied with the services. So it's very important for us to understand what are the reasons for hiring an agency. Any brand would think, koi bhi company sochegi ki why we should hire an advertising agency, agar hamare paas paisa hai to hum khud hi laga sakte hain. But there are fixed reasons, and the first and foremost being expertise and experience. The agencies are expert in the field, right? They know how to communicate. They have people who are from a different, who are master of their skills. For example, copywriters, art directors, media planners. So they know how basically the profession runs. They know basically, they are expertise in whatever field they are working for a longer period of time, right? Next reason is objectivity and professionalism, right? If you are spending a fixed amount on your campaign, अगर आप 10 लाख रुपया लगा रहे हैं अपने कैंपेन के ऊपर, यू नीड टू नो कि व्हाट इज़ गोइंग टू बी माय टारगेट एंड व्हाट इज़ आई एम गोइंग टू अचीव आउट ऑफ स्पेंडिंग दैट मच अमाउंट। तो कोई भी एजेंसी है दैट वर्क्स विद एन ऑब्जेक्टिव, दैट वर्क्स विद एन ऑब्जेक्टिव टू वेदर टू इंक्रीज द सेल्स और टू इंक्रीज द प्रॉफिट और टू मेक एन एडवांटेज टू योर ब्रांड और अ क्लाइंट, टू रिकॉल इट्स इम्पैक्ट, तो वो एक ऑब्जेक्टिव के साथ काम करती है और प्रोफेशनलिज्म के साथ, बिकॉज दे आर आंसरेबल फॉर दैट मनी, दे आर आंसरेबल फॉर द सर्विसेज दैट दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग टू यू एंड द सर्विसेज दैट दे आर चार्जिंग फ्रॉम यू, राइट। वो प्रोफेशनलिज्म होता है उनके अंदर। एंड द थर्ड रीज़न फॉर हायरिंग एंड एडवर्टाइजिंग इज कॉस्ट इफेक्टिवनेस। मतलब आपको पता है कि आप जितना पैसा लगाएंगे, द अमाउंट दैट यू आर पुटिंग इन टू योर कैंपेन इज नॉट गोइंग टू गो वेस्टेड, बिकॉज इट्स नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट कि any brand or a company in itself knows ki how to reach out to people, how to communicate in a better way. So they are the communication experts, they know how to get the desired results from the customers. Cost effectiveness hai. Hiring them leads in saving the cost up to some extent. So after understanding this, why are we hiring? Next point is ki what we should look in to कि वाई वी शुड चूज अ पर्टिकुलर एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी, वाई नॉट दी अदर एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी, राइट। सो देर आर बेसिकली सम पॉइंटर्स टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड वाइल हायरिंग एन एडवर्टाइजिंग एजेंसी जिसके लिए आप काम करेंगे, जिसको आप हायर करेंगे टू डू। एंड दिस थिंग इज बेसिकली स्टार्टेड इन टू पैटर्न्स, दैट इज स्ट्रैटेजी एंड टैक्टिक्स, राइट। सो द फर्स्ट एंड द फॉरमोस्ट पॉइंट टू बी केप्ट इन माइंड इज द प्लानिंग टेक्निक्स। सो यू नीड टू नो एनी ब्रांड, किसी भी ब्रांड को ये समझना ज़रूरी है कि एनी एजेंसी इज अवेयर ऑफ हाउ टू डिज़ाइन अ कैंपेन, हैव दे ऑलरेडी डन दिस बिफोर, हैव आर दे प्लानिंग सच गुड दैट दे विल प्रोवाइड यू द डिज़ायर्ड रिजल्ट्स। सो यू शुड नो दैट द एजेंसी इज प्लानिंग एंड नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग रैंडमली, राइट। So the next point for selecting an advertising agency is the objectives. It's very important for you to understand as a client, it's very important for me to understand ki whether the agency is working with an objective, because we have told an agency that we want more sales. So are they working with an objective to increase our sales? If we say that we want to increase the walk-ins to our showroom, are they working with an objective to increase our walk-ins? So what questions to be kept in mind is, do they focus on your primary objectives? Do they know how to assess the effectiveness of advertising and determine whether the agency is meeting these objectives? And the next point to be kept in mind is the target market research, right? It's very important for a client to understand, does the agency know the target market? आपका product जिस target market के लिए है, क्या agency उस target market को study कर रही है या उसको उस चीज़ के बारे में awareness है, या are they putting up any steps to get the information related to that particular market? So this is very important as a client to understand. Persuasion research findings. Are they familiar with the extensive research findings on how to persuade people? For example, whatever research findings you have got, किसी भी agency को जो भी research से उनको जो भी results मिलते हैं, क्या वो agency उन results के basis पे अपने लोगों तक पहुँचने की effective measures ढूँढ रही है? Right? Is agency capable of doing it? That these are the certain pointers to be kept in mind when we are thinking ki wo agency strategically kaam karti hai ya nahi. Another thing as a client that we need to understand is ki agency kyun choose karti hai koi advertising agencies is uski techniques ko dekhkar. And the first and the foremost is the creative techniques. That means as a client I'll be testing ki what techniques and procedures are they using to enhance the creativity of my product. As a client, मेरे लिए बहुत ज़रूरी है समझना. Copy alternatives. What copy alternatives would they consider and why? For example, if our slogan is not going good, if our punchline is not effective enough, So do they have an alternative? Ki how can we make it more effective? Next is copy testing. What procedures would they recommend to test and select the most effective of their copy alternatives? It is not that any agency or any copywriter in an agency would think of a one punchline and would go, ki let's go with this. It does not happen this way. So what are the measures to test ki whether the copy is going to be effective or not? Whether people are going to like this punchline or a slogan or not? Right? So this is a technique for copy testing. Next is media alternatives. In case, as a client, it's important for me to understand, in case my ad is not working on one media, it's not working on one medium, do the agency have the tie-ups with the alternatives? If my brand is not going with the newspaper, so do they have the options for radio? You know, as a client, it's very important for me to understand. Before selecting an agency, I would keep these things in my mind. Media testing, right? How would they determine the optimal amount to spend on an advertising campaign, right? It's not that the client is giving me 10 lakhs, so I need to spend that 10 lakh, you know, without planning, without thinking. So I need to understand, ki is the agency justifying the amount that I'm giving to them through various mediums, right? So that is very important for me. Capabilities of the team, you know, is the team that the agency is working with, matlab unka client servicing, unka media department, creative department, are they capable enough to provide us the desired results? Right? और ये बहुत चीज़ें कई बार when the client is negotiating with the advertising agency, ये बहुत चीज़ें तभी दिख जाती हैं. Right? This is the first time, and when you are interacting with an agency, the client, in case the client is very sharp enough, they would catch these things on the very first meeting. And the seventh is the taste, legal and ethical guidelines. Right? So what are the procedures that the agencies, in case the brand is, you know, caught with the certain unethical or with certain copyright issues, so what are the steps, you know, or what are the procedures that an agency takes to handle with those things? You know, do they have effective measures to save their brand? You know, what are the processes? Have they handled this sort of a case study before? Right? So these are the pointers that needs to be kept in mind when you are selecting an advertising agency, right? So I hope you have liked my video and the information about the advertising agencies, departments and the functions of an advertising agency. So I hope you've liked my video, and in case you've liked the information, do subscribe to my channel, and you can also share your feedback at kalia.gitanjali@gmail.com and subscribe it to, or you can subscribe it to www.gitanjalikalia.com. Thank you for watching.